The Great War seriously undermined the global perception of superior Western values. It plunged the world into new barbarism. An entire generation was brutalized and embittered. The German people were subject to a savage punishment for the mistakes of their leaders. The Wall Street crash of 1929 caused a seismic shift in the international order. Millions became jobless, and millions more were plunged into poverty. There was a global sentiment for change. Liberal democracy was under threat like never before. Economic depression laid fertile ground for the rise of communism. Terrified at such a prospect, the anti-communist right wing swung towards militarism and fascism with the promise of a strong nation. Democracy in Italy, Japan, and Germany turned sour under the heat of economic depression. In Italy, Mussolini became more radical after the Depression. In Japan, imperialism was seen as the only solution for Japan's problems. In Germany, Hitler seized power and began to build what was to become the world's most efficient and brutal war machine. The defenders of the current civilization were few indeed. Amongst them were Britain and France. Both nations possessed empires that totaled a third of the world's surface. Neither state, however, had enough money or resources to defend such a vast empire. The fashionable view was that empires were a source of political strength and economic nourishment. This led the three revisionist nations to conclude that their only chance of salvation was in attaining an empire. In 1931, Japan annexed Manchuria with little repercussions and later waged war with China. In 1936, Italy supported the nationalists in Spain and invaded Abyssinia. And Germany capitalized on the fear and appeasement of Britain and France and began to remilitarize the Rhineland, annex Austria, the Sudetenland, and eventually the whole of Czechoslovakia. Hitler also signed a pact with Stalin to avoid the mistakes of his predecessors. But Poland was the red line. When war broke out in September 1939, there was widespread fear in the West that the march of Hitler's brutal armies signaled the end of Western civilization. The three revisionist powers vowed to establish a new global order. On the 27th of September 1940, the Axis powers signed the Tripartite Pact that unified their global ambitions. By 1941, the Wehrmacht had conquered most of Europe in what had been an extraordinary display of military might. The French were crushed within 6 weeks, while the British retreated at Dunkirk. The Italians had gained dominance over the Mediterranean and North Africa, while Japan established its hegemony over Southeast Asia. Barbarism was taking the world hostage. Hitler now turned his attention eastwards, towards Russia. Lebensraum was a long-desired goal for Hitler, and now was the opportunity to achieve that goal. The rich steppe areas of Ukraine, the abundant oil of the Caucasus, and the iron and steel basin of southern Russia all provided the necessary economic nourishment for Hitler's empire. Only the Red Army stood between Hitler's goal of world domination. By late 1940, Hitler began to draw up plans to invade the Soviet Union. Stalin was advised numerous times by Soviet as well as British intelligence of a large buildup of German troops in the east. He dismissed these warnings as fear-mongering. On the 22nd of July 1941, the biggest land invasion in history was conducted, Operation Barbarossa. Three million troops marched eastwards with the intent of seizing Moscow, Leningrad, and the industrial south. In the first few months of the war, the Wehrmacht were triumphant. It was the Japanese attack on Pearl Harbor on the 7th of December 1941 that tipped the balance of power, as it dragged the largest industrial power into the war, America.
I ask that the Congress declare that since the unprovoked and dastardly attack by Japan on Sunday, December 7th, 1941, a state of war has existed between the United States and the Japanese Empire.
By early 1942, the Axis were reaching the limits of their power as they began to face logistical problems, although this wasn't known by the Allies at the time. Hitler would often ignore the advice of his generals, and this would cost him dearly. The fear of global Axis enslavement mobilized the Allies to attain total victory at all costs.
We shall fight on the beaches, we shall fight on the landing grounds, we shall fight in the fields and in the streets, we shall fight in the hills, we shall never surrender.
By 1943, the Allies had managed to outproduce the Axis in every department – tanks, aircraft, trucks, ships, and so on – while also adapting to the conditions of mobilized warfare. 1942 to 1944 saw major turning points in all the theaters of war. In 1943, Sicily was captured. By 1944, the Deuce was overthrown. Japan had lost the Battle of Midway and the Battle of Coral Sea. And on the Eastern Front, the Germans had lost the Battle of Stalingrad and the Battle of Kursk at the hands of the Soviet steamroller. They were now in full retreat. On the 6th of June, 1944, the Allies had launched the largest amphibious assault in history, Operation Overlord, better known as D-Day. A combined force of over 150,000 Allied forces stormed the shores of northern France. It was the final blow to Nazi ambitions. In 1945, the Soviet Union and the Western powers competed over capturing Berlin. On the 30th of April 1945, the rapid advance of the Allied armies confirmed that Axis victory was impossible. Hitler had committed suicide. On the 8th of May 1945, Italy and Germany were finally liberated.
General Eisenhower informs me that the forces of Germany have surrendered to the United Nations.
But the Japanese fought on. President Harry S. Truman decided to deploy the world's first superweapon, the nuclear bomb. On the 6th of August, 1945, Hiroshima was obliterated by a nuclear bomb. 150,000 civilians perished instantly. On the 9th of August, 1945, Nagasaki was also decimated by a nuclear bomb. 75,000 civilians perished. At the mercy of these destructive weapons, Japan surrendered on the 15th of August 1945.
General Douglas MacArthur has been appointed the Supreme Allied Commander to receive the Japanese surrender.
Although many reports suggest that they were pursuing peace through neutral countries before the deployment of nuclear weapons, but it was simply ignored. On the 2nd of September 1945, the most brutal conflict in human history that cost the lives of over 50 million people was finally over. It was a Pyrrhic victory for everyone involved, apart from the USA. For more content like this, please like the video, subscribe to Global Frontier, and donate if possible.